You've heard the saying, time is money, and it is. Perhaps that's why we complain about travel. How can we get there faster? Can this experience be better? We dream about moving comfortably from place to place in the blink of an eye. That's essentially the dream of the Hyperloop.
What exactly is the Hyperloop?
It's very similar to an airplane on high altitudes. You have a low pressure environment inside the tube, a capsule that doesn't touch anywhere, hovers, and then because of the low pressure, doesn't encounter a lot of resistance.
How do you envision the Hyperloop changing the way we live?
To connect two major cities that are normally 6, 7, 8, 9 hours apart within 15 to 30 minutes changes the way we live. We're living in areas that are completely overfilled. We're sitting in traffic every single day for hours.
And you think the Hyperloop could be the solution?
I think the Hyperloop is for sure one of the solutions.
A possible solution, maybe, but it's far from a reality. This concept of humans traveling around in tubes has been around for more than a century. Then, in 2013, Elon Musk drafted up actual blueprints and put the challenge of building it to the engineering community. And as it turns out, there were a few willing to try. Hyperloop Transportation Technologies took on the challenge, but quickly realized they didn't have the design expertise. Enter UCLA.
The engineering aspects of this, they're actually quite simple. It's really the design that is the most technically challenging.
What's so challenging is it's an unconventional system. And so you sort of have to invent everything from the ground up. The track is an entirely different element. The station is entirely different. The process of boarding is different. So as architects, what we're trying to do is stitch together the technology, the social change, and the human experience.
So do we know what it's going to feel like to be traveling at 700 miles an hour in one of these tubes?
You'll accelerate.
And you'll feel that physically.
You'll feel that as a thrust, like a very fast, powerful car, like a Tesla. You will feel almost no sense of motion once you're at speed. You're mainly going to experience getting there and stopping.
Each year, this UCLA grad program takes on a big problem and tries to solve it. The Hyperloop's biggest problem? Making tube travel comfortable.
So this is kind of like the Hyperloop think tank center right now. What are these models over here?
So we have two sets of models. The first ones here at the back, they were really study models that were investigating. These are more of a finished product that investigate more of the interior situation and also the sitting.
So these are all the options of the capsules.
What about the
stations here?
So same thing with the station. This station is probably the most compact station. And it really, the entire activity actually happens almost here. This is more still of a lounge shopping area.
This is where you get your magazines,
yes,
your coffee.
But still everything happens on the go.
This one looks very complicated here.
Yes, it is maybe not as complicated as it is Grand. The students were really inspired by Grand Central Station, and this station really is able to hold 6,000 passengers.
6,000 passengers?
Within 1 hour. But the idea is not to be in the station, at the station for an hour. This is the interesting one because it uses a very different system. You come here on the road system, you're dropped off, and this is in a way your pod. So you need to know with your phone probably
It's almost like your terminal, which one you get dropped off
yes.
at. You're traveling at speeds of hundreds of miles an hour. How could this possibly be safe?
In railroads, most accidents were all human factors. So we're in a closed system. We're completely managed by a computer system. There's no human factor that can actually create those issues.
How much money have you guys raised here?
Zero.
How are you going to get this off the ground?
Innovation is done in teams. It's not done by a single person.
Do you feel like you're working on a project that's really going to change the future?
Oh, absolutely. If I have a date and I want to see the opera in San Francisco, I can literally do that and be back in time to go to sleep in my own house. I mean, that's the nature of the kinds of disruptive change that this can bring, and to be able to be part of this effort is a dream come true.